Anderson Cooper is keeping them honest. AC 360, CNN weeknights, 8 Eastern.
We begin tonight keeping them honest with new information that goes straight to a key question in the rape case out of Steubenville, Ohio. Was a young woman, the young woman in this picture, as drunk and incapacitated as this photo would seem to suggest? Was she too out of it or outright unconscious when the state of Ohio claims two stars of the local football team sexually assaulted her during a string of parties back in August? Now, we covered this story late last week when some explosive video was posted online when a teen who may have witnessed the alleged rape was seen joking about the incident. Watch.
Hey, what if that was your daughter?
But it isn't.
What?
If that was my daughter, I wouldn't care. I'd just let her be dead.
Nate, listen to yourself.
I'm listening to myself fine.
In about 10 years, I'm gonna come back to this video.
10 years. My daughter's gonna be getting raped and dead.
So back to the picture. Was the alleged victim in control of her senses? Could she consent to any kind of sexual intercourse? Was the photo something other than it seems, as one of the defense lawyers is suggesting? You'll recall Susan Candiotti spoke with that defense lawyer on Friday.
That photograph, what do you make of it that we have seen of some young people, appear to be two teenagers,
correct,
carrying out this young lady? She appears to be limp, being carried out by her arms and legs.
It does. The photograph, frankly, looks heinous when you look at it. I've been told from at least one witness that we were prepared to call that that scene was staged, that she was actually conscious at the time. So we're going to have to wait for trial and see what happens.
Is your client in that photograph?
I can't confirm or deny that.
So he says he's got a witness and that the girl was conscious. Now today, though, the Ohio Attorney General's office put out a whole lot of testimony from three witnesses, one of whom disputes that she was conscious. We're going to have more on that in a moment. That testimony was found within nearly 300 pages worth from a probable cause hearing that was held back in October. First, a 17-year-old who was in the car with the two defendants, Trent Mays and Malika Richmond, as well as the accuser. Now, here's his description of her physical state before leaving the second of three parties for a third party. Question, and what, if anything, did you notice about her behavior? He answers, she was very drunk. And how do you know that? Just like the way she wasn't, like, fully capable of walking on her own. Another question, and what is it that made you think she wasn't fully capable of walking? He says, she was, like, stumbling as she was walking, and we had to help her. Who's we? Well, Trent and Malik helped her. He says that on the way to the car, the young woman actually vomited. Then he testifies she ended up in the car with Mays and Richmond. Richmond in the front, she and Mays in the back seat. At that point, according to this witness, Mays began performing a sexual act on her while the witness says he was videotaping it on his cell phone. Now, the prosecutor then asked him what the accuser was doing. Answer, she was just sitting there not really doing anything. The prosecutor asked, was she making any noise? She was kind of talking, but I couldn't make out the words she was saying. Now again, all of this allegedly took place on the ride from the second to the third party that night where Malik Richmond allegedly raped the young woman. And again, this witness, the driver, says she was already very drunk back at the second party, something another witness corroborates, calling her, quote, out of it, unquote. He goes on to say it looked like the accuser was trying to go to sleep. He then describes how the two defendants got her to the car. He says, Trent was holding her by the hands and Malik was holding her by the feet. Then a question, how did they get out of the basement that way? Answer, they carried her through the door out into the street. Now, the testimony that you just heard, it sounds like an exact description of that photo. And the photo that's now become so notorious of an seemingly unconscious woman being carried by the two defendants. We do not, however, know if this is indeed what the witness was referring to. Now, this same witness goes on to say that he later saw the second defendant, Malik Richmond, perform a sexual act on the defendant. He told the prosecutor, at no time did she speak, utter a sound, or move any part of her body. In all, three witnesses testified at the hearing and were cross-examined by attorneys for the two defendants. Significantly, during the hearing, neither attorney disputed that their clients had sex with the accuser, only that it was non-consensual. Also, significantly, both accusers were present at the hearing. Now, we should mention the two defense attorneys were unable to come on the program tonight. They'll be with us, though, tomorrow night. More on the group, though, that posted the pictures and the video that have shocked people nationwide and is really tearing the small town of Steubenville apart. Our Gary Tuchman got a rare interview with one local member of the group, Anonymous. Here's his look at what makes this shadowy group tick.
Hundreds of people over the weekend gathering in downtown Steubenville, Ohio. Emphasizing the world is watching, they want everyone to know they think the Steubenville High School football culture is not worthy of more protection than a teenage rape victim. In the crowd, people with masks, the masks of Anonymous, the increasingly well-known internet subculture collective that's leading the attack on the Steubenville High School students who may have raped a 16-year-old girl, and the handful of bystanders they believe who did nothing to stop it. This is one of the people at the forefront of the attack campaign. He goes by the initials KY.
We're not really the judge nor the jury, but it's fair to say that we are the executioner. Like I said, they incriminated themselves by posting that information online. They took part in criminal activities. And if you think that they're guilty, that's because your conscience is telling you that they are guilty.
But you're saying you're the executioner. What I'm saying is, in this country, a jury of your peers or a judge needs to say you're guilty, and you're already kind of saying that, aren't you?
I am already kind of saying it. Like I said, they incriminated themselves. There's clear-cut evidence, and a jury of their peers is what they're entitled to, and are we not their peers?
This is some of what KY is referring to, a picture showing the two rape suspects carrying the alleged victim was spread all over the internet after it was reposted by Anonymous. And so was this video of a former Steubenville High School baseball player and others making vile jokes about the girl.
Hey, what if that was your daughter?
But it isn't.
What?
If that was my daughter, I wouldn't care. I'd just let her be dead.
While two Steubenville High School football players have been charged with rape, Anonymous has posted names on the internet of many more members of the team, many of whom Anonymous says saw what happened to the alleged victim that night.
Everyone who witnessed that is just as guilty as the people who did it.
Eddie Wilson and Geno Atkins play football for the Steubenville High Big Red. Wilson said he wasn't at any of the parties and witnessed nothing, but says those who follow Anonymous's information assumed he was involved.
They put my information out there and said I'm involved in this rape case. I'm one of the ringleaders. I wasn't even at the party or involved in any of this.
Wilson says he's now getting death threats from unknown people on the internet.
They sent me a picture on Twitter, and there was a group of bullets on a piece of paper, and they singled one shot out and said, "This bullet is for Eddie."
Anonymous stands by its posting of names and doubles down by saying this.
We believe that multiple people have participated in the rape other than the two that were charged.
Both football players are outraged by Anonymous's posting of names, saying they feel attacked by outsiders because of the team they play for. But they have different opinions about the allegation of rape against their two teammates. We asked Atkins if he felt they were guilty.
No, not at all.
But Wilson is more circumspect.
If they're found guilty, they need to serve prison time. If they're found innocent, they need to be let go.
For its part, Anonymous is not going to let go.
All that's necessary for evil to prevail is for good men to do nothing.
Like it or not, Anonymous is staying on the case.
Gary joins us now. So we learned last week that lawyers for the defendant said the victim sent a text saying she wasn't raped, or saying to one of the people, "I know you didn't rape me." I understand you asked Anonymous about that.
That's right. That masked man, KY Anonymous, tells us that he's uncovered tweets that indicate the alleged victim lost her phone right after that evening. So he is saying that it's very possible that if such a text does exist, someone else sent it using her telephone.